Let's start question number second of exercise 5.2. Question is find the quotients and the remainders. A part is 800 divided by 100. See, if the divisor is 100, okay, if the divisor is 100, then the number formed by the digit in the ones and tens place of the dividend becomes a remainder, and the number formed by the remaining digits will be the quotient. Okay, whenever we divide a number by 100, the number formed by the digit in the ones and tens place will be the remainder, and rest of the digits will be the quotient. So here ones and tens place, the number formed by the ones and tens place is 0, 0, and 0, 0 means 0. So your remainder will be 0, and the remaining digits, the digit left is 8 only, so this will be the quotient. Okay, so if we divide 800 by 100, the quotient will be 8 and the remainder will be 0. B part is 3200 divided by 100. See, we are dividing by 100, the divisor is 100, so the number formed by the ones and tens place is your remainder, and the remaining digits are the quotient. So the quotient will be 32 and remainder will be 0. Okay, now C part is 75,000 divided by 100. So the number formed by the ones and tens place is your remainder, and rest of the digits will be the quotient. So the quotient will be 750. Okay, the number formed by rest of the digits will be the quotient. So 750 will be the quotient and remainder will be 0. And D part is 96,321 divided by 100. See, we are dividing by 100. So the number formed by the digit at the ones and tens place will be the remainder, and the rest of the digits, the number formed by rest of the digits will be the quotient. So your quotient will be 963 and remainder will be 21. So this is question number second of exercise 5.2.